surgeons are migrating away from gamma irradiated grafts, and at the time, the only viable alternative for them was an aseptic tissue. But the aseptic tissue is not sterile to SAL 10 to the minus 6. It's only SAL 10 to the minus 3. So they approached us to find a viable alternative to create a sterile allograft at SAL 10 to the minus 6, which led us to start investigating electron beam sterilization. There are several advantages. First of all, electron beam sterilization can occur within a matter of seconds versus gamma irradiation, which usually takes about 5 to 6 hours. During that time, heat can be generated within the tissue as well as free radicals. Both of those elements can damage the collagen structure. So by minimizing the time with electron beam sterilization, you minimize the potential exposure of the tissue to those harmful elements. Secondly, electron beam sterilization is pretty self-explanatory. It uses an electron beam to sterilize the tissue versus gamma irradiation, which uses a radioactive isotope, a cobalt-60 source. There are also no additional steps within the electron beam sterilization process, such as peracetic acid. In this process, there is no pretreatment of the tissue using gamma irradiation. Also, the electron beam sterilization can occur with the tissue in its final packaging. So there is no handling of the tissue after the sterilization process. So in its final package, you have a graft that is sterilized to an SAL of 10 to the minus 6 to ensure patient safety. Electron beam sterilization is fairly new to the allograft tissue banking industry. And because of that, we wanted to examine whether the electron beam sterilization had an effect on the biomechanical properties of some of our different soft tissue allografts that are used for sports medicine applications. The purpose of the study was to compare the properties of the electron beam sterilized tendons to aseptic tendons to see if there indeed were any differences in the biomechanical behavior. We adapted an environmental chamber on this system that can create a physiologic environment for testing. And what that does then is we can evaluate how these tissues perform, how they transmit load, how they adjust under that load, under those conditions. So our environmental chamber is unique in that historically, any testing that was done on hydrated tissue was, the tissue was immersed in a saline or a water bath. But the problem is that these are hydrated tissues and they can swell. When swelling occurs, that can affect how the tissues behave. So what we did is, instead of immersing the specimen in a water bath, we lightly mist water or saline onto the specimen in order to keep it hydrated, but we minimize the swelling effects to better approximate the normal function of the tissue. We test at a physiologic temperature to create environment at 37 degrees C, which is body temp. In doing that, you closely approximate how these allografts would function inside the body versus at room temp, because collagen does behave differently at 25 degrees C versus 37 degrees C. Historically, tissues are tested to failure, but that's only part of the picture. So what we included in our testing was a sub-failure testing regime, which we were trying to mimic what are called activities of daily living. So what types of loading environments would this tendon graft see, say if the patient was walking or maybe a light jog? And so we tested that type of environment as well as the failure properties of the grafts. And we found overall that there were no differences between the electron beam sterilized grafts and aseptic grafts. We also looked at the structure of the collagen using histology. And we found that there were no differences in collagen fiber alignment, spacing, or diameter between the electron beam sterilized tendons and the aseptic tendons. So couple that, biomechanical performance is not altered, with our validation that electron beam sterilization achieves a sterility assurance level of 10 to the minus 6, now you have a functional graft that is indeed sterile and safe for the patient.